so you can get a proper Okay, so today we are going to recreate an Instagram picture over here which I have saw about 6 to 7 months ago on my feed. First of all, let me tell you, I am recreating this picture over here on my terrace, but you can go at really creative places like somewhere on the roads or any symmetrical places which will make your background looks much more better. But I'm just going to recreate over here because I'm just going to show you how to do that. In case if you don't have any water puddles where you can reflect your subject into the water surface, so you can create your water puddles on your own. Like you are not going to create any water puddles, you are just going to take your water and spread it on the surface so you can get a proper reflection of your subject. So I'm just going to spread water on the surface. I'm just going to spread as much as wide as I can so it will get a proper reflection. After long fucking time and so much tries, I got this shot. It was really hard to take this shot because the surface where I was taking these pictures was a little bit inclined on left side. So when I was putting the water on the surface, it is just going down a particular side where I don't want to click that pictures because on that side it is totally mess. And if I would have clicked the pictures on that side, the photos would have looked totally like shit. I poured that water on the surface for about 5 to 6 times, so it was really hard for me and there was no one to help me to click pictures. So I was putting my camera on the timer and clicking those pictures. So finally, and I am really happy with this. So now I'm going to put these photos into the Photoshop. So I'm going to put these photos into the Photoshop and let's see what we can do with this. Okay, so let's name this. Layer in which I am standing is layer number 0 and the layer of the background is layer number 1. Okay, so we are going to put layer number 0 on the top of the layer number 1. We are going to select the layer number 0 and decrease the opacity a little bit so we can see the behind the layer we are going to decrease the opacity so we can see the layer which lies behind the above layer. So we are just going to adjust this layer and change the scale. If you want to change the scale of any photo in Photoshop, just hit Ctrl T. So I'm just going to change the shape of this image and I'm going just to fit this image into the image which lies behind this image. I hope you understood what I said. Okay, so we are just aligning this part over here. Okay, after this we are going to just take the erase tool and this is the erase tool and we are going to take this erase tool and change the size of this erase tool by brackets and we are going to make this size much more bigger so we can get a smooth feather. And we are just going to remove my body from this like this, and you can erase all the other parts which lies in the photo. And yeah, like this. Just if you want to feather it out, just make the brush size bigger. If you want to zoom, you can go over here and zoom into your photo and and remove these shoes and be very careful while doing this and decrease the size by using bracket keys. And you can do this like this. Okay, anyway, I'm not going to show this whole process of masking out. You know how to do this. So this is what I got. I know after doing only Photoshop, the photo is going to look like shit. But trust me, when you are going to put that photo into Lightroom, you can use Lightroom mobile or Lightroom PC. Both are almost same. And give some dark moody color correction, so it will match the theme of that photo. So yeah, that was for today, guys. If you enjoyed this video, just don't forget to like this video and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel if you enjoyed this video. And okay, subscribe, like and share. Anyway, see you in the next video.